Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Hyundai or Kia with a 2.4 GDI engine. You need to remove or replace cylinder head or cylinder head gasket. Stay with us, we'll explain how to do that step by step. Very detailed video that will be long, but I promise we'll share quite a bit of detail and everything that you need to do to remove that gasket if you need to replace it, and we'll talk about the torque specs as well. Also, if you want to know the symptoms of bad cylinder head gasket or bad cylinder head, we'll have the video on the channel as well. Check it out. Now, before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos for you guys. If you need to buy any parts to cylinder head gasket, new bolts, anything like that, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our tools and supplies from. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So this is a GDI engine that we have. That's how it's going to be practically in the vehicle, guys. Everything comes with the cooling system, exhaust system. We got it out so you can see. It has been used in multiple Hyundai and Kia models as well, so you can find it on multiple cars. Now, this is your exhaust system on the back side. You can see this is the exhaust manifold right here. This is the upstream oxygen sensor flex pipe, and from here you're going to have the catalytic converter. After that, it has only two bolts where exhaust manifold attaches to the catalytic converter, which is actually located okay right here. You can see that's where the two bolts go, and this is the downstream oxygen sensor. Now, in order to remove the exhaust manifold, what you will need to do, make sure you work on cold car, let it sit overnight, everything to be cool because it will be really hot. You need to remove three bolts for the thermal shield, and right here, okay, while we're removing those, you have two clips for the oxygen sensor wire. Make sure, okay, you spread them to get the wire out, and later when you install the wire, make sure you push them in so the wire doesn't come out, because if it does, it touches the exhaust and it burns, guys. Ours burned right here because somebody didn't install it correctly. Now, that thermal shield will come out. From that point, there is one hidden bolt, okay, that actually on that vehicle it wasn't even installed last time, so we will explain where it is. Here you have two options: to disconnect the exhaust manifold from that gasket right here, okay, or you can, guys, go ahead, okay, and do it from the catalytic converter. It's one of the two. If you do it from the catalytic converter, okay, you'll need to disconnect the exhaust, actually there, the exhaust vent as well. So what we'll need to do now, okay, we need to disconnect the upstream oxygen sensor. So we pull it out of here, and what we have to do now, press here and disconnect it. Perfect. Now here, that engine, we're rebuilding it. Somebody cross-threaded, okay, the exhaust manifold bolts as well. So here we want to show you what we'll be doing. We have a few, okay, bolts that we need to remove. One in the corner there, one in the top right here, it's missing two, then we have three right here. Sometimes you get just the nut, sometimes will be the stud will come out. Okay, right there. And here we have three more that we need to remove. Okay, and you can see we're almost there, guys. We just have one more that we need to remove, and it will come out. Those will be usually tight. You may soak them with rust penetrating spray, let them soak for a few hours and try to take them off. Make sure you don't break them. And now it will have one more bolt, okay, and let me show you where that bolt will be located. I need to come on this side. The hidden bolt will be underneath, guys. This one is missing, like most of things whoever worked on that car. Right there, you have one bolt on the bottom. You can see where it will attach to that metal holder. And once you remove it, okay, it will need to come out. Okay, perfect. And the gasket itself, okay, is right here. This one is a bad gasket because the bolts weren't tight, and as a result, not tight enough. As a result, it was leaking. So I want to show you where we have, okay, exhaust leak right here. You can see this is an exhaust leak here, exhaust leak on the other side, multiple exhaust leaks. So that's how you guys do it. If you look at it now, okay, what do we need to do here? We need to grab the upper engine cover and just grab and pull out. It attaches with four rubber bushings to these four posts right here, and make sure that the bushings are not stuck here. If they are, you need to remove them and install them on the cover, so later you can install the cover. Now, in order to remove the valve cover, okay, whether you're removing the valve cover or replacing a valve cover gasket, you will need to do quite a bit of work. So first, you will need to disconnect the car battery. Why? Because you will be disconnecting the fuel lines and you will be leaking fuel, and if you have sparks, okay, you can catch on fire. On these modern cars, it really matters which battery terminal you disconnect, reconnect first. If you do it the wrong way, you can cause damage to the engine computer. So we have a special video that explains that, and I will put the link in the description of the video below. Number two, guys. Gotta make sure that your engine is really cool. Let it sit overnight, because if it's hot and you spill fuel, you can catch on fire. Number three, you need to disconnect the low pressure fuel line. Okay, the video is on our channel, how to disconnect fuel line on a Hyundai. Check it out, it's super simple and it will teach you how to do that if you don't know how to. Then, what else you need to do? You need to disconnect, okay, the wires, okay, for the pump here, okay, for the high pressure fuel pump. Now, on the back side, you will have a wire for the, okay, this is for the variable timing solenoid for the exhaust camshaft. Okay, and you're going to pull it this way. Right here, this is the PCV valve. Okay, just grab the hose. If you have a clamp, you need to remove the clamp and pull it out. Here, you need to remove the safety clip, okay, on the ignition coils, and then if it doesn't want to come out, push in, then press down and disconnect it. You can see it just like that, pretty simple. Be careful not to break those, because, okay, try to disconnect them with your fingers, because if you break that one, okay, that safety thing, okay, your ignition coils may get loose. Now, we're going to disconnect the fuel line right here with a 3/4 inch wrench. You will always have fuel pressure. Always use eye protection and gloves, guys. So be careful, because most likely you will leak fuel. We may not leak any fuel because we removed the engine. Okay, so probably we leaked all the fuel out because we had a few things disconnected before. 10 millimeter socket, and we're going to remove, okay, that wiring harness from the valve cover now. So let's go ahead and do that. Perfect, it's loose. One more there. Okay, great. Now, you can see it comes to the side, like that. Now we need to remove the fuel pump, high pressure fuel pump. Go a little bit on each side, and then remove it all the way. That fuel pump will be under pressure, because right here the fuel pump camshaft follower, also known as tappet, could be on a high point in the camshaft. Ours is not. Now, I recommend to inspect your camshaft follower tappet and replace it if you need to. We have a special video that explains, okay, the 2.4 GDI engine noise because of a bad fuel pump. So check it out, engine noise 2.4 GDI. Now, we'll remove the ignition coils. And we just noticed now one of them is missing. You're supposed to have a bolt right here. Somebody didn't install it. We'll be rebuilding that engine, and in the meantime, we want to teach you how to do things so we can save you as much money as we can, guys. Perfect. Now it is right here, so let's see what else we need to do. Okay, we're going to go ahead and remove all the inner bolts of the valve cover here. Now, we can go ahead and
Remove these two. Now all the bolts need to come out. Why? Because these bolts will fall, and if you drop one in your engine and you don't know about it, you start your engine later, guys, okay? And it's somewhere in the cylinder head, you're going to damage your camshafts, your engine, and you will need the engine rebuilt or a new engine, guys. So always have to be careful not to drop anything, okay, inside. Okay, I got these two. Okay, right there, both of them, they came out. Perfect. Now, this is the valve cover. Now, let's see if we have anything else holding. Always inspect. Okay, we have one hose. That is for the air filter. For the intake hose that goes, you can see towards the air filter hose. Okay, perfect. We disconnect that one. And now we should be able to grab that one. The fuel line may be a little bit in the way, so you need to come in an angle and the valve cover comes out just like that. So we can continue with the next step now. What we will need to do, we actually need to remove the serpentine belt. That will be the next step. We need to get the belt out, and we'll need to remove the AC compressor. So in order to do that, here we need to get a 14 millimeter wrench in our case and go counterclockwise. We will release the tensioner pressure, and that will make the belt long, and we can simply go ahead and remove it. Just go ahead, grab it and pull it like that. Next, let's explain what we need to do here. Okay, that's the AC compressor. We need to remove it off the engine block, otherwise it will not work out. You don't need to disconnect the lines, okay, and you may be able to do it without draining the Freon, but careful not to break a line because the Freon will leak out. It's illegal. And another thing, it can severely hurt you, your eyes as well, so be careful, guys. So now let's go ahead, okay, do that. So we have four bolts for the AC compressor. Two are on the bottom right here where it attaches to the bracket that is screwed to the oil pan. So we're going to do that, and then we have two more on top, one here, one on the other side, and we need to disconnect the wire as well. That wire is for the AC switch, and this one, this wire is broken. Okay, check it out, we need to fix it. That's why the AC didn't work on this car, so we'll fix it, but you need to disconnect the plug as well, which is pretty simple. So 12 millimeter socket, and we're going to go ahead, okay, and get this loose. It'll be easier if you do the top ones first, guys, because if you do the bottom ones, what can happen, okay, when you do those bottom ones, okay, the top one will not be holding it. So let's go ahead, do the bolts on top now. One is out. Now, if you cannot do it because of the AC lines, you might have to disconnect them or get a wrench, one of the two. So this one, I think the battery is weak on the thing as well, but we can just do it with a wrench, get this one loose. It's not going to work with a ratchet, either a wrench, or we need to remove that low pressure line so we can simply pull it out. So let's go ahead, do that. If we just pre-loosen it, we can simply unscrew the bolt after that. Okay, let me grab it on this side here. It was extremely tight. Okay, that's perfect. Now let's see if it's going to come out. The bolt can stay in the AC at that point. I don't think we'll even need to remove it. Perfect. It can go towards the back. That's great. Now let's do the ones on the bottom. So one bolt will stay in the AC compressor and the rest, okay, will come out. Now that AC compressor will be stuck. You have two guides, one on top, one on the bottom, and they tend to corrode sometimes. So just wiggle it a little bit, be careful, okay. And you can see right here, that's one of the guy. The other one is actually installed on the AC compressor.
Okay, and I'm talking. Okay, let me see. Right here. Okay. So we have two on top, not on the bottom. Now, next step, we need to remove that bracket. And for that specific bracket, we have 12 millimeter bolts, 2, 3, 4 bolts. Perfect. After that, for the oil pan, we will guys have multiple bolts that we need to remove with a 10 millimeter socket. We need to go all the way around. Number one thing, okay, before we start, there is another two bolts, long bolts that are with a 12 point socket, 12 or 14 millimeter 12 point socket. You need to drain your engine oil. Ours is pre-drained, but otherwise you remove the oil pan, you put a bucket or something, drain the engine oil, make sure you don't have oil, okay, in the oil pan. So you can see that silicone just here came loose. We need to find a socket that fits here now. So this is the socket, 12 millimeter. This is a 12 point socket. So let's just simply, those two could be really tight. Why? Because they hold the crankcase to the engine block, the bottom lower part of the crank of the engine block to the upper part of the engine block. So those two will be super tight. Now let's go ahead, start on the 10 millimeter and removing the bolts, okay, for the oil pan. So I'll try my best to show you where exactly they are. So one by one we start removing them. You can see the oil filter housing, okay, is right here. It stays on the engine block. Keep going all the way around. Now that oil pan usually will be glued really bad. Okay, the silicone will make it really tight, so you need to get a screwdriver kind of like and pry it on the farther sections. It's a metal one, so if you bent it, you can straighten it later. But this one hasn't been resealed correctly, so the silicone is leaking everywhere. So we'll be redoing, rebuilding the whole engine. It's barely stuck. Somebody didn't clean it when they re-glue it. What you need to do, okay, when you're doing the oil pan, guys, you need to clean the engine block really good. Get a scraper, clean everything good, clean the oil pan, make sure it's not contaminated. Use the rubbing alcohol to clean the contacting points, like the engine block and the oil pan, and then you apply the silicone. We'll show you which silicone we use in just a second. So let me just grab it quick. So this is, guys, the silicone, okay, right here. Gray gasket maker is a high temperature. This is amazing one. So once you clean everything, you're going to apply it on the inside of the bolt. And what I usually do, I go one small bead around the bolts as well. The bead should be around 3 to 4 millimeters thick, okay, around thick, and then re-glue it together. So you can see oil pan came out. So now, when you have in the car, okay, let me explain something. You will need to support your engine, okay, with a tie bar so it doesn't drop, because you need to disconnect, okay, you will need to disconnect your engine mount. Now, on the body, it will be pretty simple. Right here, what you will need to do, okay, you will need to support the engine, make sure it doesn't drop. You have one nut that you need to remove, one nut here, and two nuts here, and one bolt as well. So let's go ahead, do that. If you don't support the engine, everything will drop. You will break your car, your engine. You can break casings, you can break hoses, wiring harness. So always has to be supported, okay, and you will be able to remove it. You have three more bolts that attach to the body there, and you can remove the whole thing. Now that's the engine mount bracket here that you will need to proceed with. That bracket, okay, and the IKEA, they like to use 12, 14 and 10 millimeter. So everything now here is with 14 millimeter, except one bolt that somebody lost in the past. I just saw that, and they use a different bolt, which is actually a standard size. It's not metric,
Okay, you can see it right there. So that's always a good thing to work on your vehicle, guys. Sometimes you don't know what people do, even though the so-called mechanics will mess things up. Now right here you can see you have one guide here for the timing cover that you can spray with penetrating oil if you want, so it can soak. We done that, and one right here, because those will have quite a bit of rust built here, and if you don't spray them, what can happen actually, that cover can be so stuck that you try to pry it out and you will crack it. We'll talk about that in a second, because if you don't do it right, okay, what can happen, you can damage it and it's expensive. So just a thin spray on those two, okay, so they can actually get that special compound can work while we're doing everything else. Now we pre-loosened these three bolts earlier, remember, for the water pump pulley. So once they're pre-loosened, when you have the belt, it's easier to pre-loosen all that stuff, because otherwise in the vehicle you will not be able to use a little impact, so nothing will be holding your pulley, guys. So next, let's go ahead and do, okay, the tensioner pulley right here. The tensioner pulley, in order to remove the belt, you go counterclockwise. So this is a reverse threaded bolt, so we need to go clockwise to remove it. And in our case, it could be quite tight. So we're going to go ahead actually and get a wrench and let's get it loose. Perfect. Now, yep, it goes easy. You can see reverse threaded bolt. Now, right here underneath, we have another bolt, and this is a normal threaded bolt. This is not reverse. This is normal threaded bolt. All we have to do, go ahead, pull that one out as well. Perfect, this one came out. Now you can see even on the engine book, it says Hyundai and Kia right here. The same engine has been used on both, guys. So here, 14 millimeter, excuse me. And we need to remove the outboard pulley. Now, we'll need to get the crankshaft pulley out. Let me explain now. You will need to get special tools for that. But for any of you guys, okay, that don't want to use special tools, you can do it, but I do not recommend it. With the special tools, what you can do, remove the engine starter and install the tool on the flywheel, or you can install the tool, okay, through the casing on the transmission right here. You remove these two bolts, practically, you remove these two bolts, you install a special tool that goes in the flywheel here, so it can lock it in place and it's not going anywhere. So now, let me show you, we got our pre-loosen already because we used an impact. Okay, you can do it with an impact, but getting it tight, you cannot get the correct torque specs and you don't want to leave it loose. Even though this is a keyed pulley, it's not as dangerous as having an engine that doesn't have a keyed pulley. Now, what we can continue with, we can start removing all the bolts for the timing cover. So let's start with 12 millimeters first. Okay, I'll come in an angle like that so you can kind of like see. Okay, where we are now. So, those are the 12s. One more. I think this one we don't need to remove it. This one there, I don't think we will need to. Now we can simply start, okay, by removing all 10 millimeter bolts. Okay, perfect. Now that cover will be usually stuck really bad, as I said, because it will have silicone between the timing cover and the engine block. And if you try to pry it all at once, you can crack it. Watch how thin it is, listen now. That's super thin, super fragile. We've broken them in the past, so you have to be careful. There is a prying point here, one prying point there, kind of like they go in an angle. You can see, so you go a little bit here, a little bit there. And usually it will be stuck in these guides, but since we actually spread our stew, okay, you can see everything goes pretty easy. Otherwise, it will be really, really stuck, just to warn you about that. So you can see, and that timing cover came out. So this is, guys, the timing cover. Now, when you're ready to put it together, you need to clean everything super good. You can get a scraper and just go clean everything, make sure you don't have any silicone, old silicone like that. Okay, needs to come out. Okay, it needs to be perfectly clean. It's like brand new, where you have a contact point from the timing cover to the engine block right here. The engine block itself, you need to clean everything really good. You need to clean the cylinder head as well here, and You can see all that silicone everywhere needs to come out. You need to shine it really good. I usually use rubbing alcohol and clean everything really good so you can remove all that greasiness and engine oil. Clean the timing cover and we use the gray gasket maker silicone. You're going to apply about 3 millimeter bead and you need to apply it on the inside of the bolts. Okay, inside of the bolts and sometimes around the bolt I'll put one small bead as well and later I'll wipe it. That way, okay, you can prevent any kind of leaks, but usually you can see you have to go on the inside of the bolts because the bolts, they don't have an oil contacting point as well. So later you need to reseal your your oil pan as well after that. So now for the timing chain, the next procedure removing the timing chain, there are two things that people usually do, guys. Number one, you can set the engine at TDC point, top dead center. How? You just put the timing cover, okay, you install the crankshaft pulley and you bring it to TDC, and you need to have actually the camshafts with the dots pointing up and these two lines right here, okay, parallel to the plane of the cylinder head. The other theory is you bring the engine, all four pistons to the middle. Okay, that means that all pistons will be to the middle. They will have about that much space, okay, before they hit the valve, so that way you can avoid, okay, bending a valve if something terribly happens. I recommend to bring the pistons in the middle. That way we can reduce the risk and we will explain what else you need to do actually to put it together. So I recommend to remove all four spark plugs. In our case, guys, we can practically remove cylinder number 3 and 4 because on that engine 1 and 4 move together, 2 and 3 move together. But I recommend to remove all four of them, okay, and bring them to the point that, okay, I can see that piston is all the way up here now. Bring them to where all four of them are practically lining up. Now, let's remove on cylinder number 3 as well to have one more just in case. Okay, I can see. Now I got a screwdriver that I can see. Don't tap too much, just see where the piston is. And we're going to remove cylinder number 3. We'll put the crankshaft pulley and turn the engine, so all four pistons can be aligned practically. That way we'll not worry about smashing valves, bending valves, okay, which could be costly to repair after that. So now this one, spark plugs loose as well. All we have to do, just grab it, pull it out, perfect. And check out the difference now between cylinder number 4, cylinder number 3 goes all the way in. So what we'll do, okay, we're going to put the crankshaft pulley, turn the engine now. If you have all four spark plugs removed, the engine will turn easily by hand. Okay, what? 1 second. This one came up. This one went down, so go back a little bit. Okay, one second now. Okay, it should have gone, okay, slow. Let's align them. Okay, like that. Okay, they're about even. I'll recommend to check all four cylinders though. So next step, what we need to do, we need to remove the timing chain tensioner. This is the main timing chain. Every time you replace the timing chain or timing chain components, or you remove, you get to that point that you need to remove something, cylinder head, CVVT gear or anything like that, I recommend to replace the whole timing chain kit, including the oil pump, timing chain tensioner, because if it fails, you lose oil pressure and you can say bye-bye to your engine. So, 10 millimeter socket, we're going to remove the timing chain tensioner right now. Perfect, it comes out. Now, next step, we need to remove the timing chain guide, which is one 10 millimeter bolt. Okay, right here you can see, pretty simple. And then we have the timing chain guide on this side with 1, 2, 3 bolts with 10 millimeter. Perfect. Let's do the other one now. You can see we are advancing here, guys. So now that's the chain that's left here, and if you pull that, okay, that crankshaft pulley, it will come out like that. and you can simply remove it, okay, as well. You can grab the chain and pull it out. This is the main chain. Now, how do you remove the oil pump chain? For any of you that don't need that repair, you can ignore it, but I would recommend to do both. Never ever remove that pulley. Why? Because if you do, that oil pump is actually counterbalance shaft as well. And what can happen, okay, it will not be aligned anymore and you will have terrible engine vibrations. So I would recommend, guys, okay, to never ever get that pulley loose. What you need to do in your case, you need to remove the oil pump in order to remove, okay, the timing chain. And how you do that, now we pre-loosen these bolts, but some of them will be extremely heavy, guys, extremely tight. So with 12 millimeter 12 point socket, we're going to remove the bolts. You have 7 bolts for the oil pump. Right here you can see 1, then we have number 2. Great, watch how long that bolt is. 3. Number 4. Five. I believe we have 7 bolts. 6. And number 7. Now that oil pump, be careful, it will drop on the last bolt. You need to hold it really good because it can really drop and smash your face practically. Now, we made a mistake, guys. Okay, so let me explain what we were supposed to do first. We were supposed to remove, okay, the timing chain tensioner. The tensioner first. Right here. Tensioner needs to come out first. Okay, that's spring loaded tensioner. So I'm going to leave it here on the timing chain guide. Now, that pump, let's see if it's going to come out. It will come out like that. To watch out now, right here. Or one of the two, either the bottom or the top. Okay, comes like that. I'll recommend to remove the timing chain guide for the oil pump as well. So, before removing the oil pump, remove the tensioner guide and the other guide. Okay. We were a little bit in a hurry and we didn't do that. So, it's fine, but the correct way is to do it the other way. So, you can see this is the oil pump, timing chain, and sprocket here as well for the crankshaft. As you can see, the whole kit came out, oil pump is out as well. So, now for the camshafts, guys, next step, we need to remove camshafts. We need to remove the mount for the hypertrophy oil pump. 10 millimeter, guys, 12 millimeter, excuse me. Okay, now you're rounding the bolt, what you're doing here. So let's just switch to a different socket maybe, because this one will round the bolts. 12 point sockets are no fun. Okay, I would recommend to use, okay, the 6 point socket like that, because you can easily round those things and don't work with the 12 point sockets here. Okay, let's try this one. Pretty tight, so we're going to get the ratchet, get them by hand. You can see how we rounded this bolt. Okay, perfect. Great. Now, let's go ahead, do that. And we can continue to the camshafts after that. So that mount should come out. The whole bracket, perfect. Now the camshafts, guys, there is a sequence of removing them, not just installing. You need to start with the big thing on the front. Now we need to start them probably by hand, especially the 12s. I don't think they'll go with the machine. Okay, we're going to pre-loosen those. Now let's go ahead and remove that one. So at least we don't have to unscrew them by hand. Perfect. Now, we can pull that cap out. Perfect, comes out. Now, we need to come to this side and need to do these two caps. We're explaining about both camshafts now. Practically identical procedure, guys. So you need to put them exactly in the same order that you remove them, and that's how you're going to install them. So put them in the same order, and also make sure you don't, if you're removing a head or something, don't remove the valve tappets, okay, the valve lifters, because if you do, you need to readjust them. Each one of those has specific links, and it will take you hours, okay, to figure out, okay, where they go, guys. So make sure you number them as well. So you can see the sequence in which we go now. And we just have the last one now. Perfect. Now we're going to remove the caps exactly in the same order, okay, that they come on the car. Okay, so you grab them and you put them down. Okay, you can see how they go. Perfect, we have two more. And practically, guys, the camshafts can come out now. Let's check it out. We can lift them up and they should come loose. Okay, that's intake camshaft, exhaust camshaft. So that's how you guys remove them. So with everything removed, we can continue to the next step. In order to remove the cylinder head, okay, we need to actually come and disassemble things on this side. Okay, let me explain now to you. Okay, right here we'll need to disassemble quite a few things. So you can see we have the throttle body with the hose that we removed from the intake manifold. If you want, you can remove the hose from the throttle body, so that way we can get that hose out of the way, because we'll need to actually work on the thermostat housing. How we do that, okay, here we can flip it a little bit, okay, just like that, and now that's your thermostat housing that needs to come out, guys. Okay, the whole thermostat housing, not the thermostat itself. Here we are going to have multiple components, okay, bolts and nuts, and one of those, okay, is right here with a 12 millimeter socket. This is one of them. All right, let's see where another one is. It's on the bottom under that hose, actually right there. There will be a nut under the throttle body hose. There is one nut there, guys. Okay, that we need to get. Let's see if I can show you exactly where it's located. If you come, it's so invisible. Okay, it's down there on the side. So let's see if we can go ahead, remove that one, and oh, we'll need to remove the hose to do that. We might need to be able to remove the hose for the throttle body in order to get to it if you cannot remove that nut, because otherwise it's almost impossible, as you can see. So in my opinion, guys, okay, let's just go ahead and remove that hose from the throttle body. It's just 10 millimeters, so we can have more room and not to flop that big thing. Here we have one, okay, here we just have to disconnect it, okay, from let's see, right here we already have it disconnected. So all we have to do, okay, just the clamp, we have it loose, okay, right here from the throttle body. So all we have to do, just get it out. Okay, so it's out of the way and it's not here. Now this is the hose, and if we pull it that way, you're going to see that nut, okay, is actually right there. So that's what we're trying to do now. Okay, don't drop the nut now. You have to be careful. I see how it's gonna fall on the transmission housing. Okay, it's down here. So let me pick it up. We have one more bolt that we need to remove. Okay, the other bolt right here you're going to have that thing will be for the wires. Okay, it will be installed right here. What you need to do, you need to press that clip up, the other one down on this side. Ours is broken. And when you do that, underneath there is one more bolt. And we're going to leak coolant, even though it's drained, you still have some coolant, guys. Now the pipe right here is going to come from the water pump housing. When you pull the, when you pull actually a little bit the thermostat housing, you can see it's going to do that. You can, for the cylinder head, practically even leave it like that. Oh, nope, the bolt is there, so we need to just keep pulling. Okay. You can see it came out like that because you have that bolt with the nut, otherwise it's not going to work, guys. And you can see the thermostat housing came out. Now we can continue with the next step. Also, right here, we need to disconnect. This is the camshaft position sensor for the exhaust camshaft. So the wiring harness, okay, we need to disconnect it here. And press, okay, don't pull for the wires. Try to pull for the clip itself because you can pull the wires out of the connector. Okay, that's everything I think on this side. Let's see now if we have anything else holding that cylinder head in place. If we come on the back side and inspect, I don't see anything. This is the water pump housing here. I'll recommend to replace that seal every time you remove it because probably it's old, and at that point it may start leaking in the future, guys. So now we need to remove the bearing for the first camshaft cap right here, okay, because underneath there is a bolt. So be careful how you store things. Everything needs to be wiped down and lubricated when you put it together. This is actually a triple square socket, guys. We'll put the link in the description of the video below where you can get it from. It's called a triple square socket, and this one is M12 millimeter triple square socket. Now let's let's explain something. It's super important, the sequence in which you remove the bolts, not just in the sequence you install them, but in the sequence you remove them as well. So if you don't remove them in certain order, what can happen? You can rub the cylinder head, guys, damage the cylinder box. So we start with bolt number one. Okay, right here, everything will be super, super tight. Okay, so be prepared for that. Too, too tight, by the way. Perfect, this one is out. Then we go to number two right there. Perfect, yep. This one there. Let's pre-loosen that one. We got to bolt number three in this corner. That's great. We go to bolt number four in this corner right here now. So then we go to bolt number five right here. Kind of like in a cross pattern, guys. Bolt number six over here. Okay, after that we go to bolt number seven here. 8 in this bolt. There we go to bolt number 9 right there. Bolt number 10 will be the last bolt, and then we need to just go ahead and remove all the bolts. Be prepared to have a leak. Now, one common mistake people make, I want to explain before you remove the cylinder head, that can actually cost you hours of work later, guys. If you're reinstalling the same cylinder head, okay, you need to number your valve lifters because they have specific thickness for each one of those. And if they fall out, if you put the head upside down, You will spend hours of tuning the head and trying to find out where each lifter goes and checking clearance and all that stuff, which could be catastrophic, guys. In some cases, you may not get it right. You may end up having a leaking valve or having a valve doesn't lifter knock, ticking noise that happens if you have too big of a clearance between the valve lifter and the camshaft as well. So number them. If you're planning on keeping the head upside down, or even if you're not, just remove them in that sequence, in my opinion. Put them on a box and just mark them where they go. So let's go ahead, pull each one of the bolts. Now the last two bolts, the bolts will come out, and then you need to get the washers, the one on the very left side. The other ones, the washers are pressed in the bolt, so they come with the bolt. Make sure you don't forget the washers for the very left bolts. We'll explain about that in a second. Perfect, check it out right here now. Okay, that's the bolt, that's the washer. And the same thing happens to that one right here as well. All right, perfect. Now, that cylinder head should be loose and we should be practically able to lift it up with no problem, guys. There shouldn't be anything else holding. Just again, check everything. You have leaks, you have oil coolant leaks probably coming out of it, so be prepared for that. So let's see if we can pull it up. Oh, the sensor for the fuel injectors here, guys. Hold on a second. We forgot to disconnect our fuel injectors and the fuel rail pressure sensor. What you can do, we can remove the fuel rail, the whole fuel rail assembly. That way we don't need to disconnect them. Just three bolts. Be prepared that you'll be leaking fuel. Always have fire extinguisher on the side here. One more bolt with 10 millimeter. Eye protection as well. No open flames, no open fire, have fire extinguisher. Okay, perfect. Now, those fuel injectors, they may stay on the head, they may come on the fuel rail, it really depends on how they come loose. Okay, in our case, you can see the fuel rail comes out. Okay, just like that, fuel injectors stay on the cylinder head, so in that case, you need to still disconnect them. How you do that? Okay, that middle piece, gray piece, it needs to be pressed out and then you pull them out. So that's pretty simple. And one more. Here, perfect. Now that cylinder head should come loose. Let's lift it up. Cylinder head gasket right here, guys. Okay, check it out. And that's your engine, practically just like that. So if you want to see the torque specs for the cylinder head, bolt sequence, okay, timing chain installation, all these videos will be on our channel about cylinder head, torque specs and bolt sequence, timing chain installation, there will be separate videos, so for any of you that need that information, you can just find it on our channel. Hopefully the video will be helpful to any of you that need help with that. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.